Hey there, folks, how's it going? Slightly different type of video today. Hope you enjoyed that little warm-up. That's something I do pretty much every day. Not exactly that, not in that order, not that content, but something like that, just kind of working my way into being comfortable on the instrument at the beginning of the day. And hopefully that informs maybe the way that you practice or warm up, or gives you an idea of something to do to get yourself a little comfortable on the banjo when you get started in the morning. Or whenever it is that you get to practice. Anyway, here's the deal with this like casual kind of vlog style video is I am about to get started on a ton of work on my website to make it a lot easier to check out all the content that I have on Patreon and everything I've got available. Just make it easier for people to check all that stuff out. About a year and a half ago, when I started doing this a little bit more seriously, it was really easy to maintain everything. There wasn't that much content out there. So you just go to Patreon and you'd scroll down to what you wanted to click on and you'd learn that. Well, there's hundreds of videos now. I think in the last like 3 months, I probably put out 60 videos, either ones that were public on YouTube or bonus content just for Patreon. It's crazy amount of content, which makes it really hard to find all of that content on Patreon. So what I figured out is that I can actually put all that content on my website. You sign up for Patreon, and it's way easier to organize all that material myself instead of doing it through Patreon. But anyway, the point is, for the next maybe week or so, maybe a week and a half, we'll see how long it takes, I'm going to focus on just reorganizing all that information, taking literally hundreds of posts and tabs and lessons and migrating them over to my website so that I can organize them however I want to. And so far as I can tell, there's not an easier way to do that than to literally just actually recreate each page on my website instead of on Patreon, which takes a ton of time. So I'm gonna try to focus on that in order to get that happening as soon as possible, which means I'm not going to be making my regular lessons for that time. Those take a while to produce and practice the material that I'm playing, if I'm learning a tune or whatever it is, that takes a lot of time and effort, obviously. So I'm trading one for the other. But a video like this is actually pretty easy to make, doesn't take too much time. Doesn't require any planning or scripts or anything like that. I don't have to write down what I'm going to say, as you can probably tell. So I can probably keep up with doing something like this and hopefully give you some useful information, something educational, something interesting, something to think about in terms of the banjo in the meantime. So maybe I'll share also a little bit of the process of designing this website. It's nothing special. It really is just going to be a lot easier to navigate all this material. As you probably know already, the name of the game with this Patreon and YouTube content is just lots and lots of information and content that you can dig through and learn from. So maybe I'll bring you along with the process of organizing that to some extent. And the other thing that I think I can do with this that I think will probably be a good use of this time is to answer some really common questions that don't really merit like a full lesson, like don't need to be an entire lesson about what picks I use, right? Except people want to know what picks I use. They want to know what picks everybody uses. So let's just talk about that. For a thumb pick, I use this Altex, this Dunlop Altex large pick that was recommended by Gabe Hirschfeld, fantastic banjo player with Lonely Heart String Band. One of my favorite people, one of my favorite banjo players, a great recommendation and the only pick that I've played with in the last couple of years. I've used Blue Chip, Golden Gate, all the picks that are worth trying. And I haven't wanted to leave these little yellow picks since, so check those out. Obviously none of this is an endorsement or a sponsorship of any kind, it just happens to be what I like. Finger picks, however, I like the Sammy Sheeler stainless steel picks. They look like that. They're very stable, they're heavy, they're loud, they're kind of hard to bend, but that's okay because they last a really long time and I don't feel like I have to mess with them too much. They just are the sound that I'm used to. I try other picks again, and I'm just used to this now, so it's what I do. The other thing people wonder about, which I can't say that I'm doing this the best way, that you should just copy what I'm doing, but it's good to know what people are doing. They wanna know how I bend the picks. What does it look like when I bend the finger picks just for my own playing? So it looks something like that. Yeah, pretty steep, not too far off the finger. That's somewhat common, but there are definitely a lot of people that do it very differently from that, so I suggest that you try that as well. So anyway, let me know what you think about videos like this and the kind of content that you'd like to see. If you've got questions that you want answered, this is a great place for some sort of Q&A on a regular basis, maybe even a daily basis, we'll see. And let me know if you have some stuff that you'd like me to talk about or cover, if you always wondered that that I don't talk about in my normal lessons. Anyway, it's time to get back to work, get back to practicing, all that good stuff. So that's going to do it for today. I'll see you next time.